in theater in high school, and we put that show on too.
Did you, who were you? Were you
in it? Oh, I was stage.
Oh, okay.
I was stage crew. I was lighting, sound.
See here. All right, so everybody is here. Just a couple, a quick little show note. We're doing another giveaway. Yep, thank you, Gwydion. It's the Dungeon Master's Little Black Book. It's two little, it's like what it sounds like. It's a little black book that has a bunch of random tables for like encounters, items, NPCs, all different kind of things to help like drop DM in somewhere and you need something quick, flip to the table, roll a dice, and it gives you, and congrats nice. Again to Loki for winning the Dragonlance.
Absolutely.
The book should be there tomorrow, which that was pretty neat. Amazon one day delivery.
Yeah, some of them I'm getting same day.
Really? Do they like drone that shit over there to you and drop it off or something? I don't
know. I've had deliveries where it was like expected delivery between 10 p.m. and 4 a.m.
Wow. Like,
all right.
All right, so last session, you all met up on the outskirts of Vogler and were headed to the town to remember, or for a remembrance of everybody's mutual friend of Ispen. Ispen, I don't remember his last name, and I don't see it. For some reason, I want to say Greenwich, but I don't know that that's right. Green Shield. I was close. Green Shield. It was Green something. On your way there, you came across a disgruntled farmer who was being chased, or thought he was being chased by something. He did not know which. You went to investigate. You saw some weird dragon-like things. Killed two of them. Cronin took a nap most of the fight. And then the other three ran off. You made it into Vogler, kind of, met everybody, explored the town a little bit, learned of the Kingfisher Festival, which is starting today, as a matter of fact. Y'all kind of had their remembrance, yesterday. Then this morning, the Derrett came and got y'all and escorted you to Thornwall Keep, where you were meeting Becklin. And she says, if you remember, she entered the room with a small wooden box. And she set it on the table and she explained that Ispen left it all for you. But it comes with a condition that since he won't be able to attend the festival, he would ask that you attend it in his stead. She opened the lid, a tear rolled down her face, and then that's where we stopped.
The box.
What's in the box? Good question.
Just gonna look in.
Is how long can I drag out y'all trying to figure out what's in the box?
Can we just like grab it and open it?
Right.
All right. So she turns the box around to y'all, and it is a green round shield. All of you immediately recall the stories that Ispen have told of how he was given this shield by a unicorn. And that was like his signature item was that shield.
Nice. I look over at Older and say, I think Older's the one that wanted to participate the most, so you interested in the shield?
Ooh, I don't have an extra hand for that kind of thing.
Oh.
So it's in the party sheet. So just whenever y'all figure out who wants to wield it, just feel free to grab it.
We definitely should bring it, but I don't know about actually putting it to use.
So go ahead.
No, I just wanted to say, like, someone who's like fighting in front would be like find more use with this.
I prefer my big, you know, giant weapon.
And I am not crunchy as I'm not tanky as we saw last week, 3 weeks ago.
Junie, what about you? Could you use a new upgraded pretty shield?
Yeah, I could probably use it if no one else can or would want to.
Yeah, it kind of ruins my aesthetics.
Alright, 1 second. Alright, there we go. It is now in your inventory, and it is a +1 shield. It should have automatically adjusted your... Let me just check. What was your AC before? Do you remember?
It was...
There we go. Now it went up there. All right, so let me unequip the shield. There we go, 19. All right, that's more like it. All right, so once Junie, once you get it out and kind of get accustomed to it, hear a throat clear behind you as Derek's there, and he's like, "I believe they are done preparing for the festival. If everybody would like to accompany me down to the docks, I do believe there are some fishing bets ongoing."
Absolutely.
Sounds good. Lead the way.
All right. So Becklin heads down there with you as everybody heads down to the docks. Let me... grab the map. Instinctively clicking on Chrome to change the music, but all right. So you return to town, and the festival's is in full swing. Villagers are going, leaving their homes, starting to make their way out. There's upbeat music throughout. Colorful banners and paper decorations shaped like kingfishers decorate the village circle. Temporary stalls sell food of colorful crafts in the center of the circle. An ancient tree provides shade for happy picnickers. From a temporary stage, a band of local musicians brings a spirited song to a close as Mayor Raven Uth Vogler takes the stage. "Welcome, friends," the mayor begins, raising her arms high. "Welcome to the Kingfisher Festival." Cheers and applause fill the circle. The mayor smiles widely. Today is a day of not only revelry, but also reflection. We are all here thanks to the courage of heroes who came before us. Let us honor our founders, our family, and all those who can't be here to celebrate today. Enjoy your festival, Vogler, and good spirits, good times, and good friends. And look to the Kingfishers for good luck. An energetic round of cheers follows the mayor's words. With that, the Kingfisher Festival is underway.
Huzzah.
Let's see here. We'll throw this music. We'll see how it's going to sound.
Hey, Night City, it's Mulligan.
And Raven.
Night City, huh?
Yeah, I don't know. Hang on 1 second. All right. As I run through here and quickly turn off everything so you don't hear automobiles and lasers in the background.
I love it.
I see you out there.
Right, clearly that's not going to work. Right, give me 1 second. All right, so we're not in Cyberpunk, so that's not going to work. All right, so it looks like the main event is the fishing. So who all was going to fish? Was everybody going to fish?
I'll try my hand at fishing. I know Older was interested in fishing.
Yes, I'm fishing.
All right. Yeah, Nia will fish as well.
All right. Junie, what about you? Are you going to fish?
I can be a very good steering squad.
All right. So who bought their fishing tackle?
Oh, shoot. Good point.
Older did.
Okay. Older. All right. So, Nia and Cronin, they do have some loner fisher gear that y'all can have. Let's see here.
In the end, just jump in the water and fish.
Spear fishing, huh?
All right, so there's... So, Older, you will get advantage on your checks that you'll make.
Yes.
So the way this works is there are 3 10-minute rounds. So it'll be 3 rounds. Each one you spend, air quotes, 10 minutes fishing. You're going to roll a d20. That will tell me what kind of fish that you catch. And then you have a survival check that you need to pass. And that's where, Older, you'll get advantage. That is, you have to pass the check in order to catch the fish. So, let's everybody go ahead. And if you're fishing, roll initiative for me. That way we can kind of get an order going. Oh, it did not take your initiative. And you'll need to redo it.
Yeah. I kind of just drew the...
Oh, so that's your intelligence. So you'll want to go... Let's see, yeah, that was the check. Yeah, in the middle under INIT.
It's okay, we got this.
Yep, there you go.
Just getting less and less.
All right, Eldir, you are up first. Go ahead and roll me a d20, please.
Ooh.
A 16. All right. So you have hooked something big. Go ahead and give me a survival check with advantage. The number... I don't want to tell you the number that you're trying to beat.
Scare you?
All right, you are, after a few minutes, you're able to wrangle up a carp that is 3 feet long. So make note of that, 3 feet. Cronin, go ahead and roll a d20. 11, all right. Give me a survival check now. You were able to roll yours up or pull yours up as well. It was a carp. It was a tiny carp, unfortunately. So it was 1 foot long.
These darn rental poles. I know I should have bought my own.
All right. Nian, go ahead and roll me a d20, please. All right, now give me a survival check, please. Let's see here. All right, so you you've got something big on the line, and right as it's getting ready to come up from the to the surface, your line snaps and it gets away from you. All right.
At least I'm better in battles.
Oh dear, you are up again. But this time you notice there's a guy standing next to you. He says, I don't know why we do this kind of stupid shit. This is just totally, totally ridiculous. So go ahead and roll your d20.
Oh no.
And now when you roll your survival check, since this guy's kind of being a little belligerent next to you, it is just normal, not at advantage.
Oh no.
You're barely able to get this thing out of the water. You struggle with it for a little bit, your mind elsewhere to the jerk next to you, but you're able to get up a little tiny eel that's 1 foot long.
What is this? Look what you made me catch. Is it the same guy I did the bet with, or is it just a random bystander?
Looks to be a random bystander, but he is dressed extremely well. Almost looks, kind of reminds you of that guy that was a butthole in the tavern the night before.
I immediately shove him off the dock.
Well, give me an intimidation check. So you try to shove him, and he looks to be a little more stout than you anticipated, probably because of his drinking. So he just kind of stands there and chuckles at you. I see you fight about as well as you handle your pole there.
Put your money where your mouth is. See who catches the bigger fish.
Let's see here. Gwydion, let me look here.
Any carp.
All right, Cronin, go ahead and throw me another d20. You do not catch anything. All right, Nan, go ahead and roll me a d20.
I look over at the bystander and I glare at him.
Give me an intimidation check there, Cronin. Let's see here. And he is unimpressed by you as well, Cronin. Nian, go ahead and give me a survival check. You are able to fish up an eel that is 1 foot long. All right, the last round. Eldir, go ahead and roll me a d20. all right, go ahead and give me a survival check normally. All right, you get it up. It's a tiny eel worth a foot long.
You scared away all the carps.
Cronin, go ahead.
Ooh.
Ooh, give me a survival check, please.
Nice.
Ooh.
You are able to get a huge carp in. Even bigger than Eldir's first one. This one is 5 feet long.
Just look over at the bystander and just smile.
All right, Nan?
That's bigger than I am.
The Junie-sized fish. Nan, go ahead and give me a d20, please.
Ooh, almost.
All right, now a survival check. All right. Nice. So you get an eel that's bigger than your first one. That is 1.5. All right. So then that concludes the contest. So let's see here. Loki, you have a total of 5 feet. Cronin, 6 feet. And Nian, 2.5 feet. So let's see here. Loki, you actually tie with the guy that you bet with. The mayor wins at 7 feet. Let's see here. Everybody gets trophies, little fish trophies, little wooden carvings. Let's see here. Yep. All right. Does anybody want to try to go again? Y'all like to move on. It's up to y'all.
I really want to push that guy in the water.
Well, we can rematch.
Go ahead and give me a strength check there, old dear. And you're trying to beat if he's got a stuff.
Strength or athletic? It's the same. Never mind.
He does have stats built out. All right. Yeah. Go ahead and give me a check, and I'll do a save to try to beat it.
Reason I think my skills are weird because some reason I have religion. What was the check? Just strength based?
Yeah. You can strength check against his save.
Ugh, dude.
Yeah, he rolled a 19. So you get into a bit of a shoving match, and he dangles you over the water, but then pulls you back at the last minute.
Wow, are they gonna start fighting?
Hey, what else is there to do here? I think
that's really it. Just the fishing, and then heading up to the battle reenactment. Let's see here. A couple of different things that can happen during the fishing is there's a rare fish that you can catch that's worth a bunch of gold. And you can also fall in the water.
Nice.
Nobody did, unfortunately.
I mean, we could try one more.
Okay, yeah, I'm good with that.
I thought Nia jumped in the water to get the fish.
No, I wish to do that. Nobody give me permission.
They'd probably get all the fish.
So go ahead and roll initiative again, and we'll go ahead and try some fishing again.
Holy moly.
All right. All right. Oh, dear. Go ahead and...
I distinctively moved away from the guy, though.
All right. So go ahead and give me a survival check with advantage then.
Yeah.
Right, you fish up a 1 foot long tiny river eel.
Dang eels.
Nian, go ahead and roll me a d20. Right, give me a survival check. You pull up that other eel's brother, it looks like. Nice. Cronin, go ahead and give me a roll.
You are a master fisherman.
I know.
Just when he
gets yanked into the water by this carp and is out of the fishing contest.
Oh.
I immediately dive in after him if I see him getting pulled and he didn't let go of the reel.
Do you let go of the reel whenever you get dumped into the water?
Heck no, I want to grab that fish, man. At least hang on until I need to come up for air.
All right, so while Cronin's struggling with the fish in the water, Ildir, go ahead and roll me another d20.
Oh my gosh.
All right, roll me a survival with advantage. All right, so you pull up a tiny carp that's 1 foot long. All right, Nian? You don't catch. And Cronin is still battling the fish in the water. So, Ildir, go ahead and roll me a d20.
Can I cast Guidance on Ildir?
Yeah, why not?
Okay.
That gives him an extra d4, correct?
Yeah, it's an extra d4.
Oh, I may have let go before I hit the chat box. Oh no, disregard, that's advantage. Four.
So roll a d4 and add it to that.
Well, that's the witch fish one, right?
Yeah, you can, in this case, since it's not like earth shattering, you can either use it now or on the skill check.
I'll do it on the skill check.
Okay, so go ahead and give me survival. All right, so now roll your d4. All right, so you get this tiny little eel up out of the water, and right as it starts to come up to you, it wiggles loose and falls back into the water.
I hate eels.
Nian, go ahead and roll me a d20. All right, go ahead and give me survival. Go ahead and add a d4 to that as well. You're inspired by Odir's guidance. You kind of overheard a little bit. All right, so you pull up a mature river eel that's a foot and a half. And Nian, you win the second round of the fishing contest. As Cronin, you finally... The line kind of goes slack as the fish has gotten away from you.
Gotcha. I come out of the water and make sure I have the pole with me and try to drive myself off.
And as you do, everybody has a good chuckle at your expense.
Everybody, Cronin of Endless Grip.
Thanks for the follow. I appreciate it.
Cronin of Endless Grip. Cronin of Endless Grip.
So, with that, Becklin and Derek kind of comes up to y'all and says, well, if y'all are done horsing around, now we can get on to the fun stuff if you'd like.
Wait, that wasn't the fun stuff?
Oh, we've got a battle reenactment to go to.
Oh, that's right. Yes, I'm excited. I even sharpened my great axe last night.
DM can never get to the map. There. All right. Oh, by the way, Gwydion, I posted on the forums about how I hate the way that they have this stuff laid out now and was basically told to make a story entry and drag all the links in it myself.
Oh, geez. You're talking about the adventures. I actually did that for the last Shadow of the Demon Lord.
Yeah.
That I actually did it in the reference manual. I just dragged the links in the reference manual on the images and it worked fine. I didn't have to create story entries.
Once we're done, I'll show you what I'm talking about. It's,
I think, yeah, sounds good.
All right, so everybody heads up. And it's kind of a little procession leading out of the town up to what's called High Hill. Passing through woods and fields, Vogler's parade of militia members and reenactment spectators finally reaches High Hill. The grassy slope is spotted with trees and crumbled stone fencing. Near the base, several dozen soldiers in matching armor stand in even formation. The contrast is striking between these mercenaries of the ironclad regiment and Vogler's militia. with their mismatched armor and crooked helmets, but it does nothing to dampen the spirits of those assembled with the Kingfisher's Festival climactic reenactment. So a couple of things that y'all would have overheard on your walking your way out to the battle or the battlefield, that this is a mock reenactment of the battle where the Knights of Salamina, their victory over enemy forces. It was led by Lord Vogler, a noble knight and the village's founder. This year, the mayor, Raven, arranged for a friend of the town, the mercenary leader, Cudgel Ironsmile, to participate. Cudgel's regiment is playing the part of the invading forces. Let's see here. And something of note, the mayor has been having the militia prep a bunch more practice and stuff like that. And there's rumors floating that maybe the mayor hired Cudgel to help with the event, to help maybe train village militia a little bit more. Let's see here. So who all was going to be participating in the reenactment?
I would like to participate.
Yeah, somebody who didn't participate in fishing. Different talents.
I think everybody was, correct?
Sorry, the reenactment or the fishing?
The reenactment. I don't recall, honestly.
Let's say everybody. It was Ispen's dying wish that everybody... Okay.
It was dying wish. Like, we have a say in this.
All right, so let's see here. So, everybody's working on getting set up. The mayor calls out to everybody assembled, explaining that the mercenaries, you know, it's the same thing every year. They'll charge up the west side of the hill while the militia and other participants charge down to meet them. The two groups will clash midway in kind of a mock pretend fight, which eventually the Astarian forces will retreat. They ask that you use your own weapons. Or not your own weapons, your own armor, and they give you wooden spears with kind of padded tips to use so that you don't accidentally kill somebody in the reenactment. They just remind you to keep your real weapon sheathed, that this is all for fun and games. Nobody needs to get hurt or killed.
Would I know, Shmo, if I assume spells are not allowed in the reenactment, that this is purely a sword and...
Strictly sword and board. I mean, after all, it is, you do just have blunt weapons. It's kind of like kind of like paintball, but with sticks and stones and stuff. Yep. After much laughter and jostling, the mayor, Cudgel, and other spectators walk to a nearby vantage to watch. As they do, the militia takes up its position atop High Hill, the same hill Solomonic troops held centuries ago. They face the mercenaries of the Ironclad Regiment at the base of the hill, arrayed as the forces of Istar once were. Although the event is only a reenactment, a tingle of excitement fills the air. Somewhere on the line, a reenactor hoots and yells, Let's send those Istarian rats running! A moment later, a trumpet blast signals the start of the battle. For Istar! Yells the mercenary leader, a tall half-orc among several mounted soldiers. The mock Istarian troops assault the hill. Around you, the Vogler militia charges to meet them. Everybody give me a perception check, please.
Sorry, you probably wanted that in the tower since it was so bad, right?
Nope, it's fine. You can leave it in the open.
Okay. I'm still wet and I'm not feeling myself.
Yeah, yeah.
Let's see here. Looks like we're just waiting on Junies.
Yes.
All right. Nian, you notice. Second. The sun appears to be glinting off one of the mercenary spears, and that they're the half-orc that appears to be leading the charge is actually wielding a steel axe. Right when that happens, you begin to hear, cries, the unexpected sound of metal clashing on armor rings across the field, silencing laughter and melodramatic boast. A ribbon of red splashes over the grassy hill, followed by shock screams. Any pretense of reenactment shatters. High Hill is the site of a true battle once more. Within moments, all around you, armed mercenaries attack unprepared villagers fighting for their lives. Everybody, roll initiative.
Just because I'm very dumb, how do I have it tracked with my initial?
So you can, in the, what do you mean, roll initiative?
Yeah, so like, okay. It's in the tracker.
So in the dead center of your screen, just to the right of your AC is, it should say, have a plus one there, and that's your initiative.
It's on the main tab.
Yeah, on the main tab of your character sheet.
Oh, and then you click and drag the dice. Oh, nat 20. Okay.
Yep.
Yeah, you can either double click them or click and drag.
Oh. Whatever you did was perfect.
Yeah.
Nice. And also, if you wanted to, in the upper right-hand corner of the screen is the two little swords. You can click that. That is the actual combat tracker. You can see when your turn's coming up.
Oh, yeah. I have that open. I was okay. Just like, oh, do I like click it from there?
Which I was wrong. Is your turn?
I want to cast Guiding Bolt on the half-orc.
So he is out of range at the moment. You should be able to see there's three soldiers with horses that are coming up the hill directly at y'all.
Oh, okay. I'll cast Guiding Bolt on one of the soldiers.
No, we don't see him at all, but should we on the map?
Oh, you don't?
Yeah, I didn't see it as well.
Right, hang on one second. Let me. There you go. Now you do.
Yep. Thank you.
Also, worth noting, do we have our weapons or do we have LARPing weapons?
You have your weapons. They just gave you spears to use.
Hold instead. So
yeah. Just hold so you, yeah, as a free action, you can throw the wooden crap on the ground and go to work.
Yeah, of course. I toss it away. No need.
Where did you say that they were coming from?
They're down at the bottom, like southwest. Yep. If you scroll back on the map, you should see them.
And so just
also, yeah.
Just also with the, so the stuff around the edge, which is called the fray, which is, looks like leaves or fire almost, that's like the outskirts of the battle. You don't want to get in that. That would be very bad.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I'm going to cast Guiding Bolt on the first one.
All
right. Like the first one to the right.
You've got their horses, and then you've got the riders that are on them.
I'm going to cast on the ring. Uh, 21 to hit?
Yep, it hit.
Uh, 16 radiant damage.
Oh, nice. Yes, it definitely hits. Let's see here.
Doesn't Guiding Bolt give advantage to the next attacker, too?
Yes, it does. It does give advantage.
Yep, so there should be an effect on there that you should click, and it should apply it to it. Yep, there we go. Let's see here. Reading here, control my train except a rider. Initially control my changes to match yours when you mount it. Alright, so it looks like if I'm reading this right, the horse shares the mount, the initiative with the person riding it. And it's the person's action to control the horse. Alright. And let's see here. Trample. Okay.
Yeah. It effectively, for like non-intelligent mounts, it's just the rider has that movement of the mount.
Yeah.
Unless, and the only thing special really comes into play if they have mounted combatant feet, but it doesn't take an action to control it. It's just,
okay.
It's his movement.
Okay. All right. So let's see here. They are going to. I think y'all have behind the stone walls. All right, so y'all have half cover at the moment.
Nice.
Which I think, what is that? Is that a -2 or -5?
I think it's 2, but I don't know. Maybe you know more, older. Not a.
-2 sounds right. So we'll go with,
Is there a cover effect?
Is there?
Oh, right. There should be in the,
Yes, it's a +2 to AC and dex saves that we okay. get.
And so this guy is going to throw his spear at Cronin.
Wait, what?
You're like right up front.
Nuts, man. I never am up front.
Yeah, I would have been likely up front.
I'm kidding. I'm totally kidding. No. Go up. Go for it.
+2 yeah. for partial, no. +5 for three quarters.
FYI, in the modifiers, by the way, Shmo, there is a cover for the attack. You can always click on that before you attack. Just FYI. Not that it matters.
Say that again?
In the modifier button at the top right in Fantasy Ground, if you click on it, there's actually a cover button when you're attacking.
Oh, okay.
No big deal. Either way works.
All right, here we go. Cover -2, that didn't do right.
I have a 15, so it's whatever. I guess I have a 17 with the cover.
All right, so it still would have hit then. Ranged weapon is.
As a reaction, bad. Can I cast shield?
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, I'll do that, which is plus 5 until the start of my next turn.
All right, so let's see here. So the horse. Whose speed is 60.
And I'm not sure if you if we did this intentionally, but the horse is the one who took the damage from Guiding Bolt instead of the Ironclad Regiment guy.
Yeah, I think, Junie, weren't you targeting the horse?
No, she wasn't.
No, I wasn't targeting the horse.
Oh, okay. Well, then that's a little different. Let's see here.
The horses are innocent. The horses did nothing wrong. They're just following the horse.
All right, so this guy would be dead then.
Oh.
That horse would be down there. Cronin, you can have your mage armor back, or would you have done it right off the...
Yeah. No, the mage armor I had said before, but I can take the shield back.
Yeah, you can take the shield back. All right, so there's that. So this guy here, give him his hit back. And a line, so without anybody steering it, he's just gonna kind of chill. All right, Ildir, you're up.
Okay, I'm gonna run up to this wall and look over. I see those two guys. I will pull out one of my javelins and chuck it at the front rider.
All right.
Actually, bonus action, rage.
All right.
Now pull out the javelin and throw it.
Nice. I love it.
Angry yell.
22 to hit.
Oh.
It should apply. It didn't apply my rage damage. Oh, rage is probably melee only.
Let's just double check.
Yeah, 2 melee.
Okay.
But that's my turn. I hit the dude man.
All right. Then just down arrow in the combat tracker.
Got it.
All right, Cronin.
All right, Cronin's going to stay where he is. And you don't really hear him saying much, but you see him whispering something under his breath. And he is going to cast Dissonant Whispers on the mercenary number 7. I think I'm targeted.
It fails.
Okay.
And he just kind of grabs his head, and then what's that? Some kind of like kind of damage? Psychic damage? Yeah. He kind of grabs his head a little bit, and then just slumps over in his saddle.
Does that log give cover at all, or no? If I were to use
The log gives. All right.
Wherever I need to be, like right behind.
All right. Yep. You're good. All right, Nian.
Finally, this entire time I cannot see anyone. I'm like hidden behind this bush.
Let me out. Older. Run to the side and throw a spear over it.
Let me out. Give me vision. Where are they? Oh, I see.
Only one left. At least right in front of us.
Okay. I guess I'm going to do the fire thingy because, you know.
Fireball?
The fairy fire.
Fairy fire. Or maybe entangle. But can I like entangle only him instead of the horses?
No, it would be the horses as well.
Yeah. I guess I'm gonna do so. It's not gonna kill them.
Alright, so you want to entangle them then?
Yeah.
Alright, so control and let's see here. The 11 there. So control, or hold down control and then left click on both the horse and the mercenary there.
Okay. I'm struggling here.
Let's see here. You should be able to hold down the control button, then left click on. There we go. I got him selected for you.
Okay, maybe I was selected, but I didn't know.
So now hit the little dice icon next to Entangle. So that should have done it for both. Try it again. Just click the little dice icon on your character sheet. There we go. So the horse succeeded, but the mercenary failed. So now go ahead and click the little effect icon now.
Like this?
Yep, that's it. So the vines kind of grew up around the ground, and the horse was able to kind of wiggle through them, but they did end up entangling the mercenary.
Okay, so now next arrow.
Thanks for the bit, Squidian! Alright, so let me see here. Entangle, 20-foot square, starting at the point for the duration. What terrain? We're gonna do 20-foot square. Like so. So the horse is going to take off running towards y'all, but as it does so, the mercenary is going to get kind of yanked off the back of it and fall to the ground. So the horse is going to end up just running off away.
Yeah, that's good.
The mercenary being restrained. I can never remember. Let me pull it up real quick. And zero advantage, disadvantage. All right, so we can still attack. It's just a disadvantage. It's going to try to throw its spear at Ildir. And miss horrifically. You attack your nearest ally using your attack spell that will do the most damage for a spell only. Alright, so this guy's somehow throws his spear at Ildir, and it swings back around and ends up hitting him. Weird,
they're definitely not professionals.
Weird twist of fate. All right, next round, Ildir, you up? Oh, hang on 1 second. Oh,
that's right. We did special refreshing in it.
Yes. So there is an event that happens, a battlefield event that happens at the end of the round. Let me roll to see what happens. Alright, so this happens to a random player, so I'll just go in initiative order. Ildir's 1, Nian's 2, Cronin's 3, Juniper's 4. Nian, go ahead and give me a dexterity saving throw as a warhorse randomly goes running through the battlefield and runs over you, and we'll see if it knocks you over. It does. So it knocks you to the ground. 1 second. All right, Ildir, now you're up.
Alright, I'm gonna run over to the dude. Man, disregard that movement. I forget that I've been playing Roll20 so much, I right click while I'm moving to make like tracks.
I run up to the end of the thing.
All right. The
patch of entanglement. I just look at him. Picked a bad day. And I pull out my second javelin, and I chuck one at him.
All right.
I did not target him, but does a 16 hit?
It does hit. Now he... never mind, he's restrained. So do you want to make another attack against him? Because that would have been an advantage.
Dang it, it rolled.
There you go. There's your crit. The critical hit does an extra die of damage. So whenever you roll your damage, add an extra die to it.
Really?
Yep. It was a debilitating cut was your extra effect.
Oh, so it's like a critical success modifier. Yep. Got it. Wow. All right. He's dead anyway, but yes.
Yeah, so you... 11 points of damage. Describe this javelin that you throw as it hits this guy.
I assume he looks up at me as I say it, and then just before he can respond, it just fills the area that he would have spoken from.
All right. With that, you turn and look back to your companions, I guess. Or do y'all, like, celebrate or whatever?
No, I keep going. I'm looking for the next enemy.
A hulking figure swinging a formidable battle axe leads a band of mercenaries through the chaos. He cuts through the few remaining members of Vogler's militia as he draws closer.
Oh, snap. Where'd he come from?
This was the
West.
The half-orc that y'all heard earlier.
Yeah.
Hello, Mother. Thanks for the like. All right, Elodir, if that wraps you up, go ahead and pass your turn. All right, so this guy is immediately going to come down to meet you with his spear and attempt to stabby it. This guy here, he can see Nyan and Cronin. But he's going to come running up to there and then be like, holy shit, there's another person back here. And we'll stop and swing at Junie. And miss. All right, Nyan, you are up.
Yes. Now you can't use my feet.
You are on the ground, so do you want to stand up?
Yes, I do. Right. Don't feel like fighting from, you know, laying position. Even though it's like, there's mercenary that is close, I would attack the orc, half orc.
All right. Let's see here. So, which were you going to do?
I'm gonna do the fiery fire.
So I think, isn't there something that happens, Ildir or Gwydion, if you use a ranged spell with somebody next to you?
Rage spell attack. This one's going to be a save.
Okay, it's a save. All right, yeah, you're good then.
Disadvantage.
Yeah. Right, so yep, you're good, Nyan. Go ahead and proceed.
What just happened?
Oh, hang on. That was way too many people. Plus, they all succeeded. Yeah. So let's see here. So it should be those there. All right, so now try it again.
still seems too much.
Yeah, that's weird.
No, it did it, but for some reason it's doing it twice.
Yeah, let's try it again. So just click the little dice icon once. There we go. Fail, success. All right, so the important one failed, the big guy. So go ahead and click the effect. All right.
Once he does that, you can probably just move that 20-foot square, or because it's concentration, so the entanglement should drop too.
Alright, Nian, if that reps, yep, go ahead and pass your turn.
Did I have, moved the square, earlier, before the attack? I think I did that before, right?
Well, if you're doing Fairy Fire, it's a concentration spell as well. So you would drop concentration on the entanglement to cast Fairy Fire. But the square doesn't exist anymore, because the square only exists for targeting, and then whoever it applies for, you just keep it while you're concentrating.
So can I see? I know. Obviously, I probably heard the big orc guy. Can I see him yet, or no?
You don't see him.
No, I see him. I just don't know with the. I can't tell if I have him blocked.
So I can't. For some reason, the player vision preview is not working. Can you actually see him?
I guess I can see him. So I guess that.
Yeah, if you can see him, you see him.
All right. So, Cronin raises his hand towards this massive orc, and you see this greenish-black ray go flying towards the orc, and you see Cronin's
Thank you eyes for the hydrate.
Briefly, and he unleashes this stream.
A lot of crits today.
Did he succeed on his saving throw?
He did succeed, yes.
Okay, he still takes the damage, but not the effect, so I'll drop the damage down.
Alright. And 2-1 hit point minions friendly to you appear in random spaces next to you. We'll just say that you've got 2-1 hit point NPCs next to you to where if they attack you, they'll attack them instead.
Okay, and I'm going to... Let's see. I'll stay where I am for now, but I am going to actually, you know what? I'm going to move just a little bit back up here. I'm going to use a bonus action to use two sorcery points, and I'm going to give myself another. I'm going to get back that spell slot I just used.
All right. I don't know, Eldir. I like flumps. I wouldn't want to do that to one of them.
I was trying to see if it had a sound effect.
Oh. Alright, Junie, you're up.
Alright, I would like to cast Inflict Wounds on this mercenary in front of me.
Alright.
Does a 22.
It does hit, but if that is... Oh, it's touch, yeah. Yep, so yeah, it hits.
16 necrotic damage.
Yep, and that kills him right there.
What?
I don't want to describe if this was Demon Lord, I would have some very descriptive stuff for you, but he gets really sick and dies.
Nice.
Perfect.
Check that. And he did guiding. Well, that was earlier, so that wouldn't count.
Yeah, right. So I have one. I have one.
I wouldn't count the guiding bolt you did in town earlier.
Oh no, that was guidance.
That was guidance. Okay, and that's right. You did guiding. Yes, you got one star left. Okay.
Yeah, I got one.
That's right.
I guiding bolt the fish.
She guiding bolted Illidir, who was trying to fish.
So it's your fault I got all the eels.
All right, so this guy here is Gonna go charging forward with a spear. Swing. Miss. Goes to 0-1 hit points and falls unconscious.
Wait, what?
Yeah, so the NPC critically failed, went to 0 hit points, and fell unconscious. They will regenerate 1 hit points at the start of their turns for the rest of the encounter.
I don't know if we ever had such weak enemies.
The DM's just rolling really crappy right now.
Let's take it while we get it.
All right. So this dwarf, or not this dwarf.
Half-orc.
Is going to move down here. Let's see here. What is this guy's reach? Is 5 feet. And swing with his battle axe. And miss. Right. So our random battle effect is a volley of arrows. Right. So let's see here. We'll just go Eldir's 1, Nian's 2, Cronin's 3, Juni's 4. Juni. A volley of arrows falls on a random player. That character and each player within 10 feet, or each creature within 10 feet, must succeed on a DC 12 saving throw. So go ahead and give me a dexterity saving throw, please.
Okay. Do I still have the +2 from the half cover?
You do not, because this kind of just falls directly on top of you.
Okay.
But it does kill the guy next to you.
Yeah, I'll say, does he pass the save?
So that fails. You take 3 points of damage. There you go.
Okay. So I'm a 19.
Yep. Yeah, I bumped it on you already.
Oh, okay.
Let's see here. So that was that. All right. Next round. Eldir, you are up.
Wow. All right. I smile at Grog, at the half-orc that just tried to strike at me. And I pull out the great axe, spin it, and then take a strike at him. I'm going to be doing this recklessly.
All right. And you hit recklessly.
Wow.
For minimal damage.
Jeez. All right. That's my turn.
All right. Mercenary number 17 is going to swing at you or poke at you with a spear. Hit. Minimal damage. Well, either the rolls have been small or max. All right, Nan, you are up.
Okay, I want to come closer to the half orc.
Okay.
Oh, I just realized I wouldn't have had to reckless, but I'm going to do it anyways because he's fury fired.
Oh, yeah, that's very true.
Yeah, I just climbed the wall, guys.
It's a baby wall.
I'm using a dagger.
Alright.
Like, stab, stab.
What cantrips do you have?
Do you just drop the...
Yep, yeah, just the D20 plus 3, just drop that on him. Out to the right of dagger. Yep, there you go. And then the damage, the same thing. Drag the damage over and drop it on him. Cause... Oh, no, not that. So you should see the 1d4 plus 1 piercing. Yep, there you go. Let's see here. So you do have... I need to build that out. That way you'll... You can do Shillelagh as a bonus action, which would make your quarterstaff do a little bit extra damage if you wanted to.
Okay.
But let's see here. So that... You moved, you attacked. Do you want to do anything else?
No.
All right. Ronan, you're up.
All right, so Cronin looks at this half-orc and he yells as loud as he can. He puffs his chest out and he says, "Your mother's human." And he's going to try to taunt him.
It failed. That's something that I've never...
What that means is... Oh, sorry, go ahead.
Maybe like you were like too far away, like he didn't hear you, right?
No, he failed. The creature failed. Yeah.
Oh, the creature.
So, yeah. So he has disadvantage on attack rolls against all targets other than me until the start of my next turn.
Okay. Ooh, that's interesting.
I don't know why I'm the effect. I do have the effect. No, I don't. You can create it real quick if you want.
Yeah, that's fine. And I'll just remember to do that.
Yeah, I'll do it next time because I think I can do the... Actually, you know what? It's probably easiest to just...
You can do like a if not true Cronin disadvantage attack.
Yeah, I'll have to do that later. You're right. So I'll do it next time, I guess, if you want.
Okay,
I will then, for my action, I'm going to cast Firebolt at it.
All right. It hits.
Why did it have advantage? It's fairy fire.
Nian fairy fired him.
Jeez. Okay.
All right, number 20. Seeing Nian run up and stab its boss in the butt is going to come up and poke at you with its spear. Four points of damage, and you succeed on your concentration, so Fairfire's good. Alright, Junie, you're up.
Alright. Am I able to still see the half-orc, or do I need to move in order to see it?
I don't think you can see him. I can't see what you see.
Behind the tree.
Okay. I'm gonna move over. I'm gonna move. And then I'm going to use last spell slot for another guiding bolt on the...
Alright. All the damage, yeah. So that guiding bolt hits him and just ignites his ass on fire as he kind of just falls to the ground dead.
Oh, perfect. And I'm going to give like a thumbs up to Older and Mia.
Let's see here. Guards. Second. Right. And then if that wraps you up, you can pass your turn as the random event is another soldier popped up. And Ildir, it is your turn.
All right. going to strike the one in front of me.
By the way, Gwydion, this is the Shadow of the Demon Lord soundtrack we've been listening to.
I was wondering. Cool.
And a miss.
I will move around, though. And get right there.
Yeah, so defocus on him, not me.
Yep. Oh, let me push the arrow. There we go.
Alright, so this guy is going to attack with a spear. And miss. Alright, Cronin.
Oh, that was quick. Alright, so I forgot we re-roll. How far away is this guy? 40 feet. All right. So he's gonna move up at least just behind the log, and he's going to cast Sacred Flame at this guy.
He succeeded, right? Yep.
All right. That's all he can do.
Give me 1 second. Ability, a druid spellcasting ability is wisdom, yes. See here. Rolls of the melee. Magical spell ends when you cast again and let go of the weapon. Alright, Nian, so what I did is I built you, if you cast Shillelagh, which is a bonus action. You can do it and then still attack. Yep, you got the extra. Your quarter staff becomes magical and does more damage. Alright, so Cronin, you moved there. This guy is already there. He's going to swing at Ildir, who moved up really nice to give him some flanking. And is going to hit. And Yan, you're up.
Okay, I'm focusing on Mercenary 20.
All right.
So I'm now gonna use my quarterstaff to just bonk.
All right. Alright, so you give it a swing, but it misses, still getting kind of used to it.
Okay, can I just now use my dagger?
So the quarterstaff, that actually is your attack, is that
one? Oh, my, okay. Yep. Now they missed my chance, guys.
Let's see here, and if you move to right here. When Ildir goes to attack, he'll have advantage on number 20. Let's see here. And
this song is part of the Dragonlance?
No, it's part of the Shadow of the Demon Lord.
Oh, I was like, what? I need it.
All right, so 22 swings and hits Ildir for 1 damage. Junie, you're up.
All right.
All So swing and a miss.
Yeah, that's okay. All
right. Right, so the random event is one of the Vogler militias crawls up out of the fray, looking to y'all, begging for help, as he appears to be within an inch of his life. And Junie, you are up again.
Okay, I'm gonna try to hit that mercenary again.
Alright.
Mercenary? I'm now creating an NPC for that.
Oh, a mercenary?
Yeah, that's happening.
And you get it, swing and a hit.
All the luck that DM lost is in the Junie's hands.
I think it's max damage.
Is it max? Oh, yeah, you did get max damage. Look there. Yep.
Nice. And that is going to be... Actually, I can move like diagonal and not invoke attack of opportunity, right?
Yep, as long as you don't move out of his range.
Yeah, I'm gonna move diagonally to get like in between the mercenary and the guard.
Alright.
And then that is it.
Alright, and you're up.
Okay, I'm using my dagger. It's more I can lean on it better.
So if you move up to right, come on, hey, move one more to right there, you'll have advantage on him since you'll be flanking him.
No, okay.
Oh, let me get him. There you go. So attack away.
Wing away.
And roll one more time. All right, so it's the dagger misses.
I miss everything. I should just say two distance fights.
Just fireball everything.
Yeah.
Did you want to move anymore? Or does that you gonna stay put?
I'm going to back off a bit.
All right. So if you move there, the mercenary will get a chance to attack you. Are you okay with that?
Moving here.
All right. And are you okay with the mercenary getting to attack you if you move off?
I changed the positions near the bush. It's still there. Right here.
So... since you're moving out of his range, he'll get an attack of opportunity, and he hits you. Just 1 point of damage.
Yeah. But as I'm missing any damage to them, so...
Cronin, you're up.
All right. He's going to move down here, trying to still take a little cover behind the wall. And he is going to target this mercenary and chuck something. Yeah, I think he could do that. And he's going to fire a bolt, kind of a bolt of lightning that comes out of his hand at this number 20.
All right.
He was mercenary.
And it misses.
What does that do? Jesus, so that doesn't do anything. Wow. Okay. All right.
Oh, yeah. Witch bolt does not do anything if you miss.
I think it's gone.
Yep, it's gone.
Wow. This guy's going to swing at Eldir and miss. The guard here is like, help me, please. as he looks up with little puppy dog puss in boot eyes at Junie, kind of blinking them all sad and stuff. And it's Ildir's turn.
Okay. Where's 22? Where's 20? Yep, we'll target the 122. Okay. Gosh.
Swing and a miss.
That's it.
Like all the good rolls were wasted on the big guy. I guess that's a good thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you wanting to... Okay, no, you're not moving. Fine. All right. What's up, Spinster? It is going good. I hope yours is going good as well. All right. It's going to swing. Oh, it has advantage because it's flanking. Make that attack again and see if it hits. It still misses. I think this guy here is going to swing Ildir as well. Misses. Right. So hang on, Cronin.
Yep.
The random battle effect. Is war horses run onto the battlefield? We'll just go in the order. Player number 3, Cronin, Ildir, Junie. If you'll give me a dexterity saving throw, please. Number you want to beat is a 14. You succeed. You're able to dodge out of the way as this horse goes ripping across the battlefield.
Yeah, it's not lovely to be knocked down. See, speaking from experience.
Cronin, you're up.
All right. He is going... Yeah, he's going to cast him. He's going to try to firebolt this guy as a flame comes flying out at him. Out of his hand. Awesome.
And it hits. And he dies.
And he's... We still have... Is that black? Still the entanglement? The black...
No, spell? That is fairy fire.
Okay, so that wouldn't hurt us, correct?
Oh, well, it's technically not there.
The fairy fire area or the entanglement?
Let me see if I can move it further. I can move one more. I'm trying to get as close as I can to this guard to see if I can help him next turn.
All right. Good. The guard looks at each one of you now with his blinking sad eyes. Why are you ignoring me?
Yeah, hold on, I just can't quite get there.
Ildir, it's your turn.
Raging that I'm missing this guy over and over. I'm gonna reckless.
Oh, yeah.
Look at there. You experience the effects of rage, so you're double rage for 1d4 rounds, so doesn't really do anything. But you do kill this guy.
Cleave down the middle.
Nice.
I'll come get up behind this guy again. There we go.
Right. This guy seeing his buddy just mercilessly, just for no reason whatsoever, cleaved with that great axe, is going to grip his spear tight and attack Ildir and hit him with two hands on his spear. And Junie, you are up.
All right, I'm going to move to the other mercenary to try to hit him with
the
face.
The guard blinks at you, Junie, as you leave. Why are you ignoring me?
I'll help you later! Okay? I gotta kill this thing, and then you are my next priority. This is just a little more important right now. I'm sorry.
Swing and a miss.
Ah, that's gonna have to be it. I don't have any spell slots left. I can't help this guy.
And so, Shmo, you are including flanking for next time, right? If she moved on the opposite, right?
Yep, absolutely. Yep. All right, Nian, you are up.
I can try throwing my dagger, right?
Yeah, you can throw your dagger. Absolutely.
But I need to be closer, or
no, you can
watch me, man.
Yeah, you can throw your dagger from there. Yeah, Cronin is kind of watching the back of his head a little bit. But yeah, 5, 10, 15.
I think it's like 20 feet for not disadvantage.
Yeah, so you would need to move up one more square if you wanted to throw your dagger.
Okay.
Yep, there you go. So yeah, now you could throw your dagger. And it goes wide and disappears out into the battle fray. Did you want to move anywhere else, or are you going to stay put?
I'm going to stay put and try to see my dagger where it landed.
All right. Let's see here. So our random battlefield event is a volley of arrows. So let's see here. Roll that. And 4. Who is number 4? Junie. Roll me a dexterity saving. Let's see here. Who all is around you? Oh dear. Also roll a dexterity saving throw.
I have danger sense, so this will be an advantage.
Junie, you are good. 17. All right, so nobody takes any damage from it. All right, Cronin, you're up.
So Cronin is going to pull out his healing kit and try to do what he can to stabilize this guy, this guard, with his action. If he can do that.
Yep, isn't that... You don't have to act... Is there a check for that?
No, there isn't. Not with the healer's kit. You just get to do it without rolling a medicine check.
Okay. Yeah, you stabilize him.
All right. And then with the rest of my action, I'm just going to move next to the mercenary. Other side. I'm passing my turn.
Right. So the guard kind of is feeling a little revigorated now that you've got him patched up a little bit, and he's going to stand up. And let's see here. 5, 10. Going to come around there, and he's going to join in. I'm going to attack this guy. And miss. He's still a little shaken. Eldir.
Here we go again. Reckless attacks again.
Oh, I guess he didn't need to do that because he's already advantage attack.
Oh, whoops.
Swing and a miss.
Yep, that's my turn.
All right, Nian, you are up.
Everybody's trying to kill this last guy.
You gonna move in and show him how it's done?
For my quarter staff, I need to come closer as well, right?
Yep, that's correct.
Can I, like, hit from here?
Absolutely.
You know, you guys just don't even need me here at this point.
So go ahead and try, since you did the shillelagh earlier, go ahead and do the shillelagh quarterstaff one.
It just doesn't. It was better, like, so close.
Yeah, so close.
It
was so close.
It just doesn't want to land properly.
All right. Let's see here. So the mercenaries turn. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm gonna roll a d10. He's just has so many targets to choose from. And it looks like Ildir is still got his eye. Gonna hit you. For minimal damage. Wow, all the damage. Juni, you're up.
Alright, time to hit this MF with my mace.
Swing and a miss.
A 20. Ah,
you gotta shake your computer when that happens, so it'll stop rolling.
I need to give it a good shake.
All right, random events. oh my gosh! All right.
Oh God! Another one.
See here with it's okay, so it's actually how many hit points he has. All right, Ildir, you are up.
All right, same thing.
Wow, look at everybody's initiative, too. That's crazy. Swing and a hit. And you cut him down. All right, so this guy here. You want to move over there?
Yep.
All right. So this guy here is 1, 2 is the guard, 3, 4 is Ildir. Guard might meet his maker. He does not. It's actually the guard's turn. Holy cow. Gonna attack, feeling rejuvenated, and miss. And Juni, you're up.
Okay. If I move over here, would that be flanking?
Yep, so you get advantage.
Oh, sweet. Okay.
And it's a hit.
Okay. Yes! Okay. And
you hit and kill him.
Yeah!
Alright, so that...
Finally.
Ends the initiative. Alright, let's see here. So let's take a quick little 10-minute bio real fast. I know everybody's worn out after that intense battle. So we'll pick it back up. Yes, we'll pick it back up at 50. Well, now 57 after. We'll be right back.
I ended up picking up one of the dice sets for Fantasy Grounds.
I forgot you were already raging Loki. I wasn't very smart trying to flank him, given I'm not a melee guy.
Okay, I'm back. What did the danger do in there, Ildir?
I don't know if you're talking to us, Loki, but you're not pushed to talk, I think.
I was pushed the wrong button for push to talk.
Gotcha.
Too many mouse buttons. No, I was typing danger because I think... When I did my danger sense, some sound effect went off, I think.
I think it did.
What it was.
So, Shmo, I think I did the taunt right now. What I did is I set up an effect for disattack that I can drop on the guy. And then I did a grant advantage attack on myself. And I think that way he'll have disadvantage attacking everyone else, and then it'll cancel me. I don't know. There might be a better way to do it, but that should work.
Yeah, you can do...
You can do the if-then thing, but this seems simpler. We'll see.
Yeah, I'll look it up. You can do, like a if-not-true statement or whatever.
There's a spell that does that.
I was wondering if it was Hex or something. I was looking for something.
It's a paladin spell.
Yeah, I it's funny you say that. I was looking for a paladin effect, like an ability. I didn't look at the spells. Anyway, I'll figure it. It'll work for now.
I'll find it.
While we wait, Gwydion, don't hold down control and click on a folder in Chrome, because it will open all the links inside.
Oh, jeez.
So, Fantasy Grounds Academy.
Uh-huh.
Got out real quick in chat. Shared something on the Git page. It was a sound thing that I was looking at. Maybe I'll get lucky.
The QFM thing?
No, I don't think it was. Let me see.
Okay.
And I was talking to Leirun about it.
Okay.
Stalling while I navigate. Is it the Monument Studios?
Oh, yeah. I mean, I know what it might. I've set up that player on Monument Studios. It's okay, but man, they still have a lot of work to do, but I know it's cheaper than Sirenscape.
I was looking at, it looks like you can buy some of their sound sets, and they were reasonably priced. So I was looking at buying some of them. I didn't know if you'd ever heard of them.
You and I exchanged emails on this years ago. Yeah, I mean, I did a video on them like 2 years ago. So I thought you even had a sound pack, because I own Fantasy One Complete and Fantasy Two Complete. They're really good. The sounds they have are really, yeah, they're really good stuff.
I'll have to look and see.
But they also have a player like Sirenscape where you can kind of have access to everything, and for like $5 a month. It's similar, but it's still got work to do. I don't think I would advocate yet signing up for the subscription personally.
I gotcha. Yeah, plus Sirenscape, since it's interfaced with Fantasy Grounds through all the stuff, I don't know that I would want to give that up. I like the sound effects swinging and all that stuff.
I agree. Thanks for that. I saw that, Older, so thank you. I appreciate that. I'll have to look that one up. And Rob has to have that coded out, so that'll work. Yeah, it's exactly how I set it up, so that's good. Yep.
Cool. Nice.
Let me look to see. All right, so I think everybody's here. Let me throw that in chat. If you are back, click the little ready thing. Let me get rid of the guard. I'm surprised Mr. Red Shirt Guard lived through the entire thing. I was worried about him.
He tried to help us. I don't know if he ever landed a hit. He tried.
He did try. Let's see here. Quick. All right. So, So after once they see the big half org fall, the rest of the guards the rest of the mercenaries disperse and scatter and begin to kind of clear out. And also you finally see showing up, as NPCs often do, right as the battle's over. Cudgel Iron Smile, along with the mayor and Becklin and a couple of big hulking town spectators make their way through there, and you can tell that Cudgel herself looks to be kind of battered as well. Which picture is here? Well, I can't share it with you, but so let's see here. You see Derrit is in tow as well. So the mayor arrives and she's like, oh, thank you for defending everybody. If you all wouldn't have been here, I fear that things would have been much, much, much worse. Tell me what happened? What did you see?
Well, someone who was, what was he, hired to take part in this, ended up turning his Rio blades on the crowd.
They were, Cudgels speaks up and she says, they were not hired. They were part of my regiment. The big fella there was one of my right-hand men.
Well, it would seem he changed his mind.
You didn't have any inkling?
Oh, sorry, go ahead.
You didn't by chance happen to leave him alive, did you? It's all right if he didn't. I believe we have another captive that we'll be able to interrogate. While the battle was taking place, that one of my own mercenaries snuck up and almost took me out as well. If it wasn't for Becklin here, I would have been would have met an ill-timed fate.
Good to have friends.
Do we have any
Go ahead.
Any idea what drove them to turn against you?
So she kind of goes over and grabs one of the mercenaries on the battlefield and begins to just like assault them, punching them and slapping them, wanting to know, you know, why is this going on? What's happening? How could you have done this? And she looks like she is probably getting ready to beat this person to death. But Mayor kind of comes over and puts her hand on Cudgel's shoulder and reminds her to take it easy, you know, to bind him and bring him back to town so they can interrogate him. Does anybody want to try to tend to any kind of wounded or anything before y'all head back to town?
Happy to use my healer kit if there's anybody that looks like they need true stabilization and help a few folks out just to make sure that
nobody
passes away.
All right. I'm proficient in medicine too, so I can tend to wounds, but non-magically.
So yeah, whoever
I can attempt to.
Okay. So whoever wants to attempt to, go ahead and give me medicine checks, please.
There's more for me. Can I do, like, I can take off maybe a couple of the healer kits since I don't need to roll? Or just tell me what you want me to do.
You can give me a medicine check with advantage.
Okay, sounds good.
I hate that I got on that one.
Yeah, you might have actually ended somebody instead of helping them.
No!
Like
I'm supposed to be a cleric!
Like the Operation game, you hit the sides. Scare the crap out of me. Let's see here. So Cronin and Nian, you helped some people. Faye, thank you. And they both give you some trinkets or jewelry or what have you that's worth 20 gold pieces, which I have adjusted your money already.
Awesome. Thank you.
You all help everybody back to town, head back to Vogler and head to the Rusty Crab, I think it was. Or Crusty, it wasn't the Crusty
Crab. Crusty Grass.
The Brass Crab, yes. I knew it was some kind of crab.
SpongeBob.
That's right. Let's see here. Kind of don't like how they don't have pictures of the NPCs on some of them. Got one of Becklin, but not of the one that they have of Cudgel is her in the boat. Let's see here. All right, so you all arrive back at the Brass Crab. And the villagers are kind of tended to the wounded. The mood has definitely shifted from the joyous occasion of the festival to now it's kind of a somber moment. The inside of the tavern was prepared for a night of celebration, but stuff's been cleared off of tables where people are tending to wounds. Let's see here. So the mayor instructs the townspeople to help patch up the wounded. She dispatches a band out to the hill to gather those that have perished and to see them buried. She looks to Cudgel and says, I want to know why this happened, why you were betrayed. And I think that the mercenary we captured might have the answers. I think that y'all will need to take him in a back room and have a chat with him. We need to find out why. We also need to know if there are more of them about. As you can see, we are not set up for this kind of incident.
Ronan says he'd love to have a word with the mercenary and participate in the discussion.
Me too, and I crack literally every possible bone that I can get to in my body.
I can rub someone up. I can do it. I swear. I promise. I'm ready. I can do it.
I believe you. You killed more than anyone on that field today.
Yeah, my confidence today is low, however.
Raven looks to y'all and says, I saw that some of you possess magical powers. Those might come in handy as well during the interrogation. Cudgel steps forward and says, I will help with this as well, since I have a vested interest as to know why I was betrayed. But once this is done, I will be returning to my camp to find out what in the hell is going on here. Alright, Cudgel grabs the mercenary and brings them into a back room and ties them down to a chair. Do y'all go back in there as well?
Absolutely.
Alright. Let's see here. So the mercenary is bound there by a fishing net. Who wants to take the first crack at this? Either intimidation or persuasion?
I'm happy to start with persuasion, unless Older, you'd rather start the intimidation route first. I'm fine with either.
I'll say out loud, yeah, it's probably better you be nice before the axe comes out. Because there won't be any chances to not be nice after that.
All right, Nian, I heard you were going to intimidate. Go ahead and give me an intimidation check.
Oh, nice. All right.
Yeah, quite intimidating.
So yeah, you step forward. And what kind of question do you want to ask this mercenary?
Who brought them here? Like, what was the purpose? Like, of like the situation that happened.
Who is your father and what does he do?
Give me information. Like why like, yeah, what was like the purpose of their like actions?
So he says that Gragonus hired and paid people that were loyal within the mercenary group to attack the militia during the reenactment. And his plans were to raid the town after they had finished everybody off.
Sorry, who paid? Did he say who paid? It was
Hang on. Yeah, the big ogre guy, half ogre, whatever he was. Well, Funny you put that there, Loki. The immediate first thing I said or thought was that boys have a penis, girls have a vagina. Oh, God. It's not a tumor.
He's not the tumor.
All right, who wants to ask another question?
I'll ask. I'll try to ask a question using my persuasion, if that works.
All right. Yep. Go ahead. Very persuasive. What would you like to ask?
Oh, let's see. Do we know anything about Gregonus and, you know, what his intentions were?
That Gregonus's plan was to kill Cudgel and then take over control of the Ironclad Regiment. And also, several days ago, Gregonus disappeared into the woods west of the camp and then later returned with a large sum of gold.
I will unclip one of my hand axes and ask him, where did he go? What direction when he came back with those gold? And then I, without hesitation, I just chop off a finger or two.
All right, so give me an intimidation check with advantage.
Nice. Oh!
All right. So he says that was unnecessary. I already told you that he headed into the woods to the west of the camp. And what was your other part that you had asked?
Kind of like, I guess, just a more information about like how long he was gone, just to gauge like distance and travel and all, actual direction.
Just the day he returned later that evening with a large sum of gold.
I'm not satisfied.
Well, how do we know it's really Gregonus? Like, there could be other... Oh, people could be sneaky. They're like, oh, you know what? I'm gonna kidnap you, and then you're gonna... I'm gonna take your place, and then with money. And then I'm gonna screw up everything and try to take over all the stuff. Can I try to ask him, like, what's something only Gregonus would know?
So give me, you can either give me an insight check to see if he's lying or intimidation or persuasion.
Ooh, I'm going to do, oh, it's not a machine. I'm proficient in insight from a Kendra. I'm gonna do insight.
All right.
A 9.
So you're still a little furious from the battle. Your emotions have not come under control, so you're not sure if he's telling you the truth or not.
That's 100% valid.
Somebody else want to take another stab at him as, or chop in Aldir's, methods? The whole time you see, Cudgel kind of pacing back and forth in the back, with every little thing he says, you hear her mutter something under her breath. You could tell that, if y'all weren't there, that this guy's life would definitely be ended by now.
Hey, Cudgel, you got any other questions? you know, he's got a few more fingers left.
Ask him who else is loyal to me in the camp.
Yeah, there we go.
And he was a righty, by the way.
I'll move to the other side of the tear. And just kind of like rest the axe next to his hand. Full grip on it, so you can't take it, but... who else was following Gorgonus in this?
Give me an intimidation check then. So he kind of looks at you and says, Everybody else at the camp is loyal to Cudgel. The only ones that were loyal to Gorgonus came with us to the reenactment.
I look back to Cudgel. Looks like all the ones loyal to Gorgonus are dead. Besides this one. But that's, you know, only a slight problem.
Does anybody else have any questions? Once. Twice.
Who's placing their bet?
All right. So with that, you hear a knock at the door. The mayor comes in and says, have you found out everything that you wish to know? People are getting antsy with him in here. We want to lock him up as soon as possible.
Lock him up? It's more like string him up.
There will be a time for that. He will be reckoned with. For now, we need to find out what's going on. And Cudgel's like, and I need to get back to my camp as soon as possible.
Well, Kajal, you want us to go with you and try and track down where Gorgonus went?
I don't need any help. You stay here. You help the village. I will be okay.
I feel like he will die.
Yeah, it seems... You sure you don't need help? Can we?
I am sure. I insist that I will be okay. Yeah. The mayor says we could really use your help in town as well to kind of piece things back together. Everybody is on edge right now, as to be expected.
Fair enough. Happy to help.
And so with that, the mayor Raven, she motions for two big burly guys. They come in and they grab the mercenary, whose name, by the way, is this. Svent Sunderlit. They bandage his fingers up. They put a gag on him and hood over his head and drag him out of the room, to go lock him up.
As he's walking out, I look back to him. You escaped that cell, and we will find you.
So everybody kind of gathers back into the common room. And Cudgel dismisses herself and says, I will return tomorrow morning and I will let you know what I find out. So she nods and dismisses herself. The mayor says... So tell me, what exactly did you learn from the prisoner?
Well, it seems like he only had people that were loyal to him in the, well, quote-unquote, reenacting everyone else was followers of Cudgel, which is, it seems like we've taken out all of the followers of Gregonus.
And how did he get support for this kind of treachery?
Did we ask that?
He seems like he was given a bunch of gold. We don't know from whom, though.
And where did he get said gold from?
The forest. Perhaps a tree gave him the money.
That is a bit suspicious. Did they happen to say a direction or anything like that?
To the west.
While he's asking these questions, I if there's any way for me to get a sense of, does he seem surprised, or are his reactions seem pretty honest? And
the mayor?
Yeah,
the mayor. Yeah, she is totally surprised.
Okay.
She says, well, I guess I can send out some of our local hunters in the morning to try to investigate. They're not really set up for this. They're more fishermen. Yes, I can send them out.
I think Cudgel is always already on the way, right? To investigate, I believe.
So Cudgel was heading back to her camp. Investigate to the west to see what where he might have gotten the money from.
Got it.
And we always assist in the investigation into the west, right, guys? I feel like we're totally right.
Yeah, I would love to hunt down whoever disgraced Green Shield's ceremony.
Well, you see her kind of smile a little bit, and you see a couple of the villagers kind of like, whew, kind of load off their shoulders when y'all agree to that. Thank you for that. I hate to ask so much of you after what you went through. I know it was quite a bit, but you will have saved lives, I'm sure. I will send young Darrett here with you as a guide. He's familiar with the area, and Darrett eagerly nods at this. There's old Darrett, just in case y'all forgot. Darrett.
Darrett!
So, do y'all want to head out now? Do you want to get a good night's rest?
I would certainly a good night's rest.
I would advocate for a bit of a rest myself, personally. Just replenish a few things.
All right. So we'll go ahead and do a rest. Why did I give y'all experience? That's
beautiful. Like it.
Yeah, I didn't. Where? I don't even know where in the heck to. Well, there's. Oh, I see what it's doing. So as I add encounters to the combat tracker, it automatically puts their experience into the party sheet.
Oh, wow.
Oh.
So then when I did a rest, it pushed the experience out to you, which doesn't matter because we're not doing it.
No, it's like, yeah. I'm not casting those spells. I just have to pick which spell I get for the after long rest.
You're fine. So, the morning of, you all wake up, are you all immediately ready to go back out there?
Yeah.
All right. So why don't you each give me... I'm guessing y'all are going to kind of want to be stealthy.
Yeah. Yes.
Alright. So go ahead and everybody give me stealth checks in the tower, please.
Oh boy. Mine are at disadvantage from my...
All right, what was the roll again?
Stealth check in the tower, please. Right. So you all kind of sneak through the woods, nice and quiet. Junie occasionally trips over some logs, steps on some sticks, but for the most part, y'all are able to kind of keep things under control. Everybody go ahead and give me survival checks now in the tower. Eight, looks like waiting on Bill Deers. Alright, so Nian, you're able to pick up on some footprints. Especially some big heavy footprints. So you definitely have picked up on the track of the big half ogre guy. So you track it for about an hour. But then you end up noticing some other boot prints and footprints as well. The footprints, though, are almost reptilian in nature. Some tracks that you've never seen before. You continue to track them on through the woods, and you kind of come to a clearing. Everybody go ahead and give me a perception roll in the tower. All right. So Ildir and Nian, y'all, and Junie kind of poke your way through the woods a little bit. You kind of tap Cronin on the shoulder and hey, it's this direction. And you all kind of, crawl over to the edge of, these hills and you part the bushes and look down into a valley. The woods give way to a ledge overlooking a shallow valley. In the distance, dozens of low fires illuminate hundreds of red tents. Among them move patrols of shadowy human-like figures. Over 1,000 soldiers occupy the camp. A whole army. And that's where we'll stop.
All right.
And okay. Everybody gains a level.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah!
Nice.
Level 3.
Ooh, I get to be special.
So give me 1 second. I'll be right back. Let me shut everything down. All right, there you have it, folks. Another episode of Shadow of the Dragon Queen, episode 2. If you have not done so already, enter our giveaway for the Dungeon Master's Little Black Book. It's really cool. There's all our socials. If we get it right, join our Discord, all that kind of good stuff. Let's look for somebody to raid. Come on. There we go. We are going to raid Mendari. I've watched her quite a bit. She does a lot of world building, stuff like that, 5th edition. It's really cool to see all that kind of stuff come together. Definitely check her out. Give her a follow while you're in there. Tell her that we sent you. And here we go. See everybody later.